Hey, what's good, guys? This is Nightwing 2303 from WearTesters.com. Today we got the performance review on the Nike Kyrie Flytrap. So with that being said, let's go ahead, get right into it. So the traction on the Flytrap itself is very similar looking to that of the Nike Kyrie 4. However, the implementation of the pattern is a little bit different. As you can see, the traction pattern itself is very flat, whereas the Kyrie 4s were very aggressive. Now, surprisingly enough, this actually didn't perform very poorly, even when dust was present. However, the one thing that I did notice about the outsole itself is that it really depended on the court's condition itself. And I'm not talking about the cleanliness of the court, I'm talking about the upkeep. So if you're playing on a court that is very regularly kept up, which I play on a couple of them, meaning that once a year they actually get stripped and refinished, so there's always that really nice fresh coat. That way, if dust is present, you're still able to stick to the floor. Just moderate wiping is going to be needed, and that's exactly what happened with these guys in that particular setting. However, I do play on a court that hasn't been refinished in like 30 some odd years. Even when that court is clean and free of debris, these just didn't grip to it for whatever reason. And then when dust was present on that particular court, again, lots of wiping needed, and still you're not able to really get much grip out of it. So if you know what type of court you play on, these might do well for you, mainly the ones that are really nicely kept. So if you have a nice high school and they're refinished once a year, these are gonna work really well for you. But if you play on like on a Y floor, or you know, a rec center, a vinyl floor, weird tiles, stuff like that, these are probably gonna be a no-go. Now the cushion itself is very basic, something that we'd come to expect from a budget model. These retail for $80, and you can definitely tell because there's not much in them. Not that that's a bad thing, these actually surprisingly enough feel a lot better than the Nike Kyrie 2 and the Nike Kyrie 3, and I think that's because of the Phylon that they used. The Phylon here is just a little bit softer, whereas the Kyrie 2 and 3 were super dense. And then right here in the forefoot, directly underneath the ball of your foot, is a Zoom Hex unit. It's not going to do much in terms of impact protection. In fact, you could barely feel that versus the rest of the Phylon. However, the shoe is just not uncomfortable whatsoever. I actually found these to be more comfortable, like I was saying before, than the Kyrie 2 and the Kyrie 3. Now, if you're putting them up against those guys right there, which are the Kyrie 4s, these guys were really no match for those. But if you're looking for something that offers you the court feel of the previous Kyrie models, meaning the 2 and the 3, but it's just a little bit more forgiving underfoot, these guys right here are gonna do just that. Now, materials, in my first impression, I actually stated that it felt like a cheap mesh, something that I was actually wrong about. One of the members of the design team actually hit me up and told me what the materials actually were. Turns out it's actually a really thin woven, which was crazy. Something that I still can't see, like if I just look at it, I had to actually put my camera to it and zoom in and have that thing refocus and everything. And that's when I was able to see that it was really a woven. It's still super thin though, so it feels kind of cheap. However, it's got some strength to it and it hasn't taken much damage. There is some fraying on the toe box area where I do get kicked around a lot and stuff like that, or people step on my feet, but there's been no rips or any issues like that. Now the fit is the one section that I was not a huge fan of. I really liked it from this little elastic band back. Had no issues whatsoever. In fact, I really liked that collar area. I thought it felt great on my foot. Got this little burrito style wrapped tongue. It's connected to that internal side of the shoe. It feels awesome once it's all laced up and tight. But that forefoot section, man, I couldn't get that feeling that I like, where you just feel like really snug and locked in, like a nice cozy hug. Didn't feel like that whatsoever. The more that I played in them, the more that I had to readjust the forefoot laces, and the more adjustments that I made to it to try to tighten things up and feel really locked in, the worse it felt in that forefoot section. Everything just kind of bubbles up and kind of overlaps on top of one another. Probably not ideal for those of you with narrow or normal shaped feet. However, if you're a wide footer, these guys were practically made for you. You'll be able to go true to size, no problems. Now, for those of you that are narrow footers or normal footers, are you gonna have to go down half a size to make these things work for you? Honestly, I wouldn't even try it. Lengthwise, they fit me perfectly. I could not go down half a size if I wanted to. Some shoes are just not made for you, and this is one of those shoes that's not made for me. I was not a fan of that forefoot fit. But if you like a little bit of open space above your forefoot, you like some volume and things like that, or like I said, you're a wide footer, you're probably gonna love the way that these fit your foot. Support's very basic and average, but it's got everything you need, nothing you don't. There's an internal shank plate at the midfoot section, an internal heel counter in the back of the shoe. There's not a real outrigger, but it extends just enough to where it acts very similarly to one, so it gets a pass in that section. And that's pretty much all she wrote. For a $80 budget model, I was actually fairly impressed. Again, if you're a wide footer, this is probably gonna be a shoe for you. If it were up to me, I would go with the Kyrie 4 simply because those fit me a lot nicer than these guys did. Also, the traction was a bit more consistent as well. But for this being a core model or a cheap model, whatever you know you want to label it, they weren't half bad. So like I said, that pretty much takes care of it. If you want to know more information, there's going to be a link down below in the description box. It'll head you over to Wear Testers where you can find their price, their weight, their score. Although I already said that they're 80 bucks, but that's besides the point. And if you're interested in grabbing a pair, a link to eastbay.com will be in the description as well. If you've played in these before, let me know how you feel about them down below in the comment section. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for your support. And until next time, guys, have a good one.